I'll talk to Corinne. I'll try to persuade him to at least let you see your son when you want. Oh, Kitty. Pregnancy suits you.
Thank you, Anna. That's true of every woman.
It will be a boy.
I think so, too.
It's better for his sake. We women may know more, but we pay a high price, don't we? Is this the lucky man?
Constantine Levin.
Anna Karenina.
I've heard a lot about you.
Oh, you're not the only one. He's a handsome man. May you be happy. Even half as happy as Vronsky and I are.
Sorry to have kept you.
Arriving unannounced, I couldn't expect you to see me right away.
Princess Sorokina, my son.
Your mother has told me a great deal about you.
I'm a subject she tends to favor too much.
There's no greater love than that of a mother. When you have children, you'll see.
May I speak to you?
There is no need. I know everything. I'm leaving now. The princess is going to join me in the country. Join us there. Come with us. Everything that you need there.
She's lost her soul, her dignity.
There's more dignity in her than in certain honored and respected ladies of the court.
You're an expert on ladies of the court.
I mean, at least she's been sincere, authentic.
You sound infatuated with her.
What are you saying?
You talk about her with such passion.
I'm not the one here who lost my head over nothing.
It's cruel of you to say that.
You're the one who started by talking about Anna and Vronsky.
I was only talking about Anna.
You say you feel sorry for her because you're talking about them both.
So you say.
Oh, you mean you feel sorry for her despite the fact that Vronsky chose her and not you?
How much longer will that man come between us?
I wasn't the one who allowed him to do so.
So thank you, Anna. If it hadn't have been for her, who knows?
Thank you. Love, what are you doing in the dark?
Where have you been?
At the officers' club. Jasmine was there. I hadn't seen him for months. How about you? Did you speak with Dolly? Will she intercede for your son?
When did you stop loving me?
I'm sick of these reproaches, Anna. You
Why
don't
are you
have
lying
the right.
To me? You were at your mother's.
You're spying on me now?
Why did you go there?
She's my mother. Am I not allowed?
What about me? I couldn't come with you?
I'm sorry. I didn't tell you. I didn't think it was important.
Dolly can't understand. No one can understand. Not even you.
Things won't work out. It just takes time.
You didn't answer me. Why did you go to your mother's?
You can guess why.
To beg? How much did Mummy give you?
Nothing. She gave me nothing. She asked me to join her in the country, but without you.
Why are you telling me?
Because you asked me to.
Who was she?
She?
You know.
I don't even remember her name. You can't be jealous of every woman.
I saw how you looked at her.
How? How did I look at her?
The way you used to look at me.
No. Believe me, it's all in your mind.
Are you saying I'm mad? I'm not Kitty. I'm a woman and not some kind of girl you can deceive and abandon.
You're delirious.
You will not be rid of me.
My greatest wish had been to marry Kitty, and that wish had been fulfilled. But I'd made the eternal mistake of all men. The mistake of thinking that to be happy, we just have to make our wishes come true.
A carriage. I'll take the first train to Nizhny Novgorod. I'm joining the Count at his mother's. I'm doing the right thing, aren't I?
Whatever makes you happy, madam.
Happy? Happy? What can make me happy? Life just gets more empty. It's one big lie. We expected so much from our love. Now we hate each other. I no longer satisfy his vanity. And he can only love me because he feels obliged to.
Soon.
What can I do?
only I could be something else. Not just a lover starving for his caress. But I can't be. I don't want to be. And my desire disgusts me. And that's what enrages me. And Seriosha? I thought I loved him. And I swapped him for another love. I didn't regret it as long as that love was enough for me. Love? What love? We're thrown into this world only to hate and torment each other. Deep down, we know this, despite the illusions we invent to try and forget.
What makes a family a happy one? That is a mystery that cannot be solved. Logic alone will not bring us peace, or answers, nor allow us to see beyond the grave, beyond the end of all things. Little that I know, I didn't learn from reason. I didn't learn it from books. I learned it from life. From life itself, that continues in spite of everything. I learned it from the suffering that forces us to grow.
Come on, children,
the little that I know is something quite simple. So simple that every humble person, every child knows it. We don't need to live for our needs. Passions, for our desires. We need to live for good, for truth, for that mysterious God that all things depend on. And perhaps that's why all happy families are alike. Because deep down, happiness is the same for everyone.